questioned on what do you do if you think a person might be getting into maybe trouble or something, and you want to say something to them or guide them. Okay, so I'll say, remember that everyone is operating from their level of consciousness. And what does that mean? And also you could say level of consciousness related to how much baggage you've got in relationship to a situation. So let's say, I don't know, let me try and make up a fun situation. Let's say, okay, I can make up a situation. Let's say I've got a good friend and I can see that he's stuffing his face full of donuts every day and he's obese. Now the question arises, that he's happily eating all these, you know, like 50 donuts in front of me and he's my good friend. Do I intervene and tell him, look, you know, there is another solution. I have a solution for you and please listen to me because, you know, I have a solution. There's a thing, now that's one event. Like I'm saying, this person doesn't want intervention. He's happily eating his donuts and doesn't want that. So it could be a difficult, that could be one thing. Sometimes people might be, but one of the things I try and do if there's someone in trouble, one of my favorite things to, I like to share in the group is Dr. Hugh Len and his approach to helping people, which was Dr. Hugh Len, and I've shared it hundreds of times in this group, shared again. So there was a prison for criminals, and he didn't go and meet the criminals in Hawaii. He just got their files, you know, this guy is a rapist, this guy's an axe murderer, this guy is whatever it is. And he just did the work of releasing the data, transcending the data in himself. So if you forgive someone, if you render everything that this criminal has done to other people and you make it meaningless through whatever mechanism, through forgiveness or through releasing the data until you can no longer hold it, it's like there is a connectiveness between all us all. So that's like inviting a huge amount of grace if there's karmic commissioning. And everyone in that prison recovered and they closed the prison down without him going and talking to the people. So that's one of the things of the mystic. Sometimes if you're at a high level of consciousness and you just release everything in you that you see is bad in the situation and that you're getting hooked into, sometimes a miracle. Anyway, even if the situation doesn't change, you'll see it differently and you'll be at peace for sure. So that's one of the things. Like if I speak to a person, let's say I've got a friend who likes eating donuts but doesn't, I intuit wouldn't want me to tell him you need to stop these donuts and do what I'm doing. Understand that my intervention with him will relate to how much of the stuff I processed in me. So if I'm feeling like, oh my God, you know, he's going to die of a heart attack in the next 2 months unless I stop him immediately and use force. You know, Hawkins had a book, Power versus Force. So when you're in fear and you're trying to force someone to do something and control them, it's the least effective. You might use brute force, say, if you don't do this, you know, I'm not going to see you again, or something like that, blackmailing or something. But it might work, but it's not very productive. You know, there's going to be a pushback. So as you clear your fear and your need, one of the things is there's a perception from the ego they need to change and the situation needs to change. Yeah, that somehow this is all wrong. You know, and they need my help to save them. So clearing, now when there's that perception of, you know, like you're in the rescuer or the martyr or you're in the thing, your spiritual connection is very low because you're trying to control the situation and you see it as your way of seeing it is right and what's happening as the universe unfolds is wrong. Sometimes, you know, there can be deeper, like we say with 12-step fellowships, like, you know, someone might say, oh, I need to stop this addict from acting out. And yet a lot of people in the rooms would say, no, tell them to go out and just enjoy the donuts or the alcohol and just don't try and force them to stop now, because they need to learn a spiritual lesson from hitting rock bottom, or a situation needs to unfold for them. And you trying to force them not to go into more pain, which might be the thing they need to grow. So you don't always know what's best. So if you're in this, so if there's a feeling of I have to save them now and I have to force them to see my way, I know that energy in me is going to be least effective in my, because my communications are coming from a low vibration. So it's when I transcend my fear and my need to tell them what to do, and I get into more of a peaceful state, I know if I speak to them then, it's going to be much more high vibration, it's going to be much more channeling the Holy Spirit in what I say. Also, my words will have much more power and authenticity. So there is that as well. So I personally think it's okay to speak, but I prefer, if I have to make a communication with someone, I delay it till the last, until the last possible time, until I've done most of the work I can do on it. So if I have to challenge somebody on something, and I'm feeling very angry and I feel I need to give them my advice on the situation, but I know I can wait till Friday, then I will sit with my feelings, go to the observer, pray for a miracle to see it differently, and try and get to a state of peace before I communicate with them. Sometimes if I have to speak from a place of urgency, then of course that happens. But I think when you're holding fear and a need to control a situation, there's a greater potential for it not to go well than when you feel peace and forgiveness and you speak after you process from peace and forgiveness. I think the chances of the situation resolving in a good way are much more improved than if I speak from unresolved anger and fear and need to control. So often, you know, if I release the stuff in me and take enough time, sometimes the situation automatically resolves. You know, I find that if I transcend everything I see is wrong, then the situation has a miracle and it resolves without me interfering. Or I see it like, actually, this situation doesn't actually need my interference. There's a higher wisdom that it's okay to unfold without, you just see it differently. Was that helpful? Mm-hmm. Or should I get?